Cove Home Security has always done things a little differently. Its equipment packages are made to order. It has rapid SOS to send help faster. And in 2023, this DIY home security system is making even more changes. There's a new app, new equipment, and coming soon, new cameras. But one thing about Cove has remained the same. It's really, really, really easy to install. Today, I'll walk you through the setup process for this newly improved system, though I might not need to do much since the alarm panel did most of the work. Before jumping in, here are a few pro tips from my own experience. Cove Connect is the system's new app, and unlike other DIY systems, it's not really the main source for your installation guidance. That said, I recommend downloading it first so it's ready to go when the system's up and running. Along with having the app ready, keep your username and login handy too. Cove assigns this info to you after you purchase a system, so be sure to save that email. You can reset your password after the initial login, but I suggest worrying about that after installation's complete. Next, check the box that your system came in. Make sure all your sensors and devices that you ordered are there. There was a moment during my own setup when I was convinced that Cove had shorted me a power cable, but turns out it was tucked into a fold inside the box. Last, find at least two available outlets, especially near your home router. The Cove Hub needs an outlet in the back of your router, so be sure there's space to add it on before getting started. All Cove systems are customizable, so yours might look a little different from mine. But here's what came in my kit: the new Cove Hub, the new alarm panel, two entry sensors, one motion sensor, a glass break sensor, a flood sensor, a medical alert pendant, a smoke detector, a Eufy camera, and an extra siren. Whatever your kit looks like, the basic installation process is pretty much the same. Connect your hub and alarm panel, pair your sensors, and then put them into place and confirm setup. One of the new pieces of this Cove puzzle is the hub. This big square is the brain of your home security system. It connects all your sensors and the alarm panel, even when the internet goes out. And if you set it up right, you might even forget it's there. To get started, plug the power adapter into the wall. Then connect the hub to your router with the Ethernet cable. Once the green lights start blinking, it's getting power and you're ready to move on to the next step. If the hub is the brains of your Cove system, then the alarm panel is the face. This device is where you can adjust settings, arm and disarm your system, and check live camera feed. This year, Cove updated its panel to this sleeker new version that looks kind of like an Android tablet with a stand. Of all the Cove stuff in your system, this is probably what you'll be interacting with the most, and it basically sets itself up. Start by plugging the alarm panel into the wall. The cable gives you about 6 feet of slack to place it on the wall or a flat surface. From there, the panel will prompt you through setup. It will ask you for your home network, confirmation for the hub, and move on to set up your master PIN code. Once that's done, it's time to move on to your sensors. Today's system comes with an improved setup wizard that guides you through the whole installation process. And thanks to that hub, my system already knew exactly what was included and walked me through the entire thing device by device. First on the list, entry sensors. These devices go on doors, windows, cabinets, anything that opens and closes. The alarm panel will ask you to trigger these sensors by separating the two magnetic pieces like this. Next, you can set your sensors aside or stick them into place. Of all the Cove devices I have in my system, these were the only ones to really give me trouble during installation. Part of this was because our doors and their frames aren't totally aligned. This caused the sensors to send a false signal because they thought they were too far apart and therefore the door was open. I tried the traditional placement, but that didn't work, so instead I overlapped the larger piece on the door where it was closest to the frame. It wasn't ideal and it didn't look great, but it still worked. Next, the panel will ask you to name your sensors. I did this based on location, but you can change it at any time. When your sensor is triggered, the panel will use that name. Next up was my motion sensor. My kit only had one of these devices, but for homes with multiple entrances or levels, we recommend getting more. Like the entry sensors, the alarm panel asked me to pair the motion sensor, then name it. To pair it, press the little button on the side of the sensor, which will tell the panel that it's ready to go. I put mine in our living room near the front door. Like nearly all of Cove's devices, the motion sensor has adhesive backing to make it super easy to peel off and pop right onto the wall. If you're planning on placing yours in a higher, harder to reach spot, hold off on installing it just yet. You'll need to press that button again once the system goes through all the sensors. Next up was the glass break sensor. During my unboxing, I wasn't totally sure what this was. Thankfully, the panel answered that for me. It's a glass break sensor. These devices listen for loud noises like, you guessed it, breaking glass. So I placed ours near the kitchen window. Like the motion sensor, it's got a simple button on the side that you'll press and pair it with your panel. Then peel off the adhesive backing and put it into place. These can be handy near sliding doors, windows, or anywhere with big glass entry points. Again, the panel will ask you to name your device, or you can stick it with the original name that Cove gives it. If you have a basement or leaky appliances like we do, a flood sensor is a must-have. These set off the alarm when the device senses water. It was super simple to install. Just press that little magic button again and place it near an appliance or pipes, anything prone to leaking. I slid ours under the washing machine, and the very next day.
Let's see what it has to say. Water alarm. It's leaking!
For seniors or anyone with disabilities who live alone, medical alert pendants can be an instant lifeline to help. I'm hoping I won't need this device during testing, but it was one of the easiest ones of Cove's to install. The prompt on the panel asked me to hold the button in the center of the pendant for 3 seconds, and that was it. From there, you can wear it like a necklace, place it on your bedside table, or even put it on a key ring and take it with you. Now, this isn't a dedicated medical alert system like Bay Alarm or Get Safe, but I'll link to our reviews up here if you want to see some of our favorites of those. Okay, this one was slightly confusing. When it came time to pair our Cove smoke detector, the panel asked me to press another little button to pair it, but there was no magic button. I'm not sure what happened here, but I managed to pair the device by twisting the battery case off and on just a little. Hi, quick aside here, I realized that the big mysterious button that I missed was actually in the center of the smoke detector. Don't twist it off and on. Sometimes even security experts make mistakes. It also has sticky backing, like Cove's other stuff, so I didn't have to drill any holes in the wall to put it into place. However, if you do want something more secure, it does come with screws and wall anchors. Once you're finished with all of the sensors, the system will ask you to go through each of them again, press buttons, and confirm that they're in place. In my test, I waited to place everything after this step, especially for those devices that belong higher up on the wall. Once your control panel gives you confirmation that everything's finished, place your yard sign out front. Remember that login info you were supposed to save before installing? Now's the time to use it. Cove Connect is the brand's newest app. With it, you can categorize all your sensors in your home, add Z-Wave devices, and soon, Eufy cameras. As of this video, Eufy's compatibility is still developing, so they aren't working with Cove just yet. But users with older Cove cameras, like the Cove Indoor, Outdoor, or Cami Doorbell, will be able to use their cameras with their system. That said, you can still do quite a lot with your Cove Connect app. Create automations around a huge list of triggers and actions in your system. Adjust which notifications you want and how you want them to get to you. Add up to 20 users and set up PIN codes. And choose a theme color. Installing my Cove Home Security system took around an hour total. From beginning to end, I had plenty of resources and guidance, and the alarm panel walked me through the entire process. We'll have a longer review coming soon covering what I liked and what I didn't like about this system, more details on pricing, and what all of these changes mean if you're currently a Cove customer. So like and subscribe to catch that when it comes out. Thanks for watching and stay safe.